plus 50. I am SM Salonke, working as a manager safety. I am having a total 35 years experience, and out of which 24 years in the safety field. The contents of my presentation will be, I will brief about my company and plant profile, then characteristics of the world-class safety, and then safety management at Bajaj Auto, and what practices we have achieved, we are implementing, I am going to brief it. Briefly, I will brief about my company. It is a Bajaj Auto is the flagship company of the Bajaj Group. It is having a 25 businesses. Rahul Bajaj is the chairman of the company, and Raju Bajaj is the managing director. We are having a number one exporter in terms of the share of the total production produced. About the plant, this is Chakan plant situated near Pune. We are having a manufacturing capacity of 4,000 vehicles per day, and the area is employee strength is the 1415 with 122 women employees, and 72 coverage is of the green coverage. These are the products. There are 22 models and 122 variants. These are the various rewards and recognitions we have received from CII, Prost & Sullivan, and BUI. This is the production process. We get the inputs from the vendors. We are assembled at the vehicle assembly, and then it is dispatched to the domestic and the international market. Now coming to the characteristics of the world-class safety. There are the various quotes from the world leaders. Some says that it is a destination, it is a journey, not a destination. Some says that it is the continual improvement towards the performances, that is leading and lagging. And some say that it is just a catchy frame. So another expert says that world-class safety is not an award or championship and requires a sustainable efforts. So basically, as we have seen, that the characteristics of the world-class safety includes the leadership of the management, integrated safety approach, the integration with the core business values, performance, that is leading and lagging performances to measure it, alignment with the core organizational initiatives, also important, and not limited to the safety efforts of the employees only, but extend to the society and the vendors areas also. I have integrated all these one, and based on that, I am presenting what are the safety management at Bajaj Auto and the practices we are adopted. From the basis of the company vision and plant mission, these are the plant specific and vision and mission statement, which clearly states that environment friendly and safe practices is the core value of our working to make the employees happy. That is, we call it as a yutori in the Japanese word. This is the SHG policy signed by the occupier under the Factories Act, which gives us the directive force or direction. This is the IMS certification. Recently, we have got the ISO standard, which is updated, the 2015 standard. This is the structure. Executive director is the occupier. Vice president is the manager under the factory. These are the production functions and other support functions like manufacturing engineering, then support services, QA are there. This is the structure of one particular shop where the division head is there and the other pillar members are there. So this shows the integrated approach. Safety is not made it as a separate one, but it is integrated with the other production functions. And in each shop is having safety coordinator, safety captains, and the BBS trainers. So this shows that how we evolved from the reactive to the proactive. Initially, we have started from the reactive, and subsequently, we have gone through the phases 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, we are at sustainable developments for the plant, vendor, and the society. These are the KMI, that is key management indices, key effective indices. Our KMI is the zero injury. So effectiveness is the impact on the human resource and property, and these are the various activities we are carrying out to achieve the KMI. For this, we have adopted a 9-pillar approach. SHG is one of the important pillars out of this, and there is a collaborative with the other pillars to give support and get supports from the other functions, that is JH, KK, PM, office training, education and training, like this. And these are aligned with this KMI theme and pillar to the management themes, that is the lean operations, efficient new model introduction, in-built quality, lowest cost, sustainability, capability building, and employee engagement. We have well established the safety systems, that is proactive and the reactive. Proactive is for the happened cases, and reactive is the for the happened cases, and proactive for the prevention. Now I will explain best practices we have adopted. This is the safety patrol. The beauty of this one is we have ensured that there is the involvement of each and every members from the plant head to the cell level members. As we know, in Henry's theory, we have to hit the bottom so that the upper top of the triangle will not get activated. So we are forcing so that realization of the unsafe act and conditions maximally. For this, we are carrying various types of safety patrols. One of these is the cell safety patrol, wherein cell is audited at a micro level, having a specific requirement of that cell. And in shop safety patrols, it is ensured that local level management is involved in identifying and correcting these things. And the benefits are mentioned here. These are some of the check sheets used for this one. So one of the important practice we have adopted from the Toyota, that is the safety observation tour, wherein there is the involvement of senior management, including the plant head, where every month he conducts the safety observation tour, wherein calendar is provided and the methodology is followed like this one. It starts from the safety board assessment itself. And the effectiveness is that since the responding agency is the part of the team, it gets immediately resolved. So the time of responding is becomes very, very less. These are some of the snapshots and check sheets are used for this one. And if lacunas are identified, they are related to the systems. What is lacking in the system, and then they are corrected to it. Even we involve outside experts for this conducting the SOT. This is another patrolling or audits carried out, that is inter-plant safety audits. The experts from the other plants are involved, and they are checking, varying itself from the what are the good practices implemented there. The HD is carried out there, and they are verifying with the legal compliances. Another is the electrical safety audit. We have developed a safety manual, electrical safety manual, and which is given to the other plants. The benefit is the electrical unsafe condition identification, and overall there is the awareness in the electrical safety. The another practice carried out is the hazard identification risk assessment, wherein here more focus is given on the engineering control than the PP or the administrative control, and more than 70% controls are now engineering controls. Here I will show you the one example. Here, in place of administrative control for the robotic safety, we have human sensor is provided, that is banner safety laser scanner. If there is any entry of a person, it gets robot working gets stopped. Can you click? Stopped and the signal is there. Another practice for identification hazard is the job safety analysis. Having unmanned operations or where the criticality is more, we are conducting the job safety analysis. We are using the auto-guided vehicles for manless movement of the material in the vehicle assembly shop. And there were the near-miss incidences while operating these AGVs. So we have studied these in details and observed that out of 108 controls were adequate and 22 were inadequate. So engineering kaizens were made there, and they are made safe. Here is the one example. Small video clip. The Pulsar assembly shop. Material is handled initially from the trolley management area, trolley is lifted, and then it is, yes, the sensor is there. So if any obstruction is there, it will stop. Then this is loaded, unloaded at the assembly line. First it checks whether the path is clear, then only it puts the trolley there. Now I will show here the before and after condition. See there, earlier it was directly put. When trolley is there, there is chances of incidences are there. Now they are completely resolved. Another is the new equipment assessment. Before putting any equipment into the operation, it is critically checked, safety assessed, and then only it is put into the operation. Though there are the check sheets at the design stage itself, but there is chances that some may get they are missed out. So it is the check sheets are provided there, and there some of the example is like this one. Now another here I want to mention the best practice recently we have adopted is the hiarya. So it is a Japanese term, means experience like accident like situations. So it is in between the near miss and the unsuspected conditions. Nothing has happened, but like there was a totally chance that something may happen. So here is the, we have developed this methodology and format is used for this one. So this is a deeply activity to capture the accident like situations. So this has again given the confidence that nothing will happen in future. These are the formats used for this one. So another good practice which we have started is the safety, employee safety concern. If the employee is invited to give their concerns about the safety, and we are asking them to report their concerns in the board which is provided in the shop. So they have to write their concern there, and the methodology is made that within this period they have to clear, the shop manager has to clear this one within a week period. In case of emergency there is no such restrictions, they have to take the action immediately. Such formats are there and they are insured. So this is the new issue. As we said that contract work, nowadays contract employees are engaged for the support functions, material handling activities, and the barrier or criticality is the language, their knowledge are the problems. For this one, we have a deeply system of ensuring, for example, toolbox talk, then the training. We have developed a safety park where the practical training is given to these contract employees before they are engaged on the job. These are the safety passports to people who are working at height. They are gone through this system only, methods only. These are the some equipments, and contractor daily work monitoring is there. And every month, on 25th of every month, we are conducting safety supervisors meeting. And one of the important point here is the we have developed one registers wherein his all equipments are checked and they are confirmed there. What are their employees are there, and every month they are assessed based on their whole month activities. How many permits are there, if any deviation is there, that is confirmed. These are the boards. Here again, not only the safety officer or the contract supervisor role is there, work engineering department and where who is awarding the contract, they are also equally responsible, and they have to visit the area every 2 hours. These are the some provisions made on the shop for having welding and other activities. These are the some of the snapshots where authorization of the drivers who are shifting the vehicles, area barrications, lotus is used not only for the electrical but the other energy sources is there. Then fire safety, we are having a full-fledged safety, fire safety arrangement. The effectiveness of fire system and other emergency situations are checked through mock drills. We are conducting the total evacuation mock drills in the plant level, and also at shop level mock drills are conducted based on the HIRA of that particular area, and it is assessed. So HIRA contents are like this only. Another is the one, here is the one example. We are having a direct online system, so we are not storing the paint or the thinner. For this, we are just material is or paint or thinner comes only 4 hours back, 4 hours period, and they are stored before they are taking into the use in the cabinets. As we know that this triangle air and heat, so fuel is there. So air and heat are removed this one from this area, and these cabinets are these cabinets ensures that 3 to 4 hours they will withstand with the fires. This is the auto messaging system used in case of any gas leakage. So response time is reduced. So this is the motivation is very important. Not only annually we motivate them, but spot appreciations are also there. These are the motivational during the presentations. We are asking the employees to participate in the skit competitions. This is the various participative forums. Like this one, the training is there. The practical demo is given, not only theoretical one. And these are the KYK trainings. So where the when the safe mind is safe even in the unsafe condition, that is followed there. And BBS trainings are imparted. Peripheral safety is taken care of. These are some of the snapshots. And the safety visual management is like this. So we are not limiting. Safety gate is provided on the e-shop. And then legal compliance is very important. And tracking system is there. MA alerts are generated. And it is ensured that they are legal compromises are met within the time period. So near me, in the reactive way, near miss are captured and first aid cases are analyzed deeply with the stratification. This is one example for the ergonomic improvement. Can I have or we can skip it? Okay, thank you. Sir, let it be. So this is the major investment done. And with all these results, we are able to achieve major and minor accident sustained zero. There are the first aid cases, but we are striving again to make it zero. So this is the future plan. So online permit system, HERA expert in each work area, like this ones. Thank you.
Thank you. Another good thing was the TPM structure with safety integrations. 9 pillars of the approach: reactive and proactive safety approach, safety patrolling, safety observations, inter-plant audit, electrical near miss, JSA, employee safety concern, and also the safety of the contract work. Now, if there is any question, please.
The way for the AGV and the operator is the same.
Yeah.
And suppose if the safety sensor of AGV malfunctions, then what will happen? Is there any control?
No. For that ones, we are a practice of JH. So before putting any equipment into the use, first it is checked daily before it is putting into the operations. So it is ensured that all safety parameters are there. So that is, I am saying that it is integrated with the other functions. So it is checked.
But in between, suppose the sensors gets failed.
So that's why we are tracking the record. As I said, in job safety analysis, we have seen that all 132 cases we have seen. And there we have observed that at 22 locations or cases, the controls were inadequate. So we have made that correct.
And how the AGV batteries are, how the operator knows that the battery is full charged? And during operation, the battery gets discharged.
No. There
then
is
how he comes to know.
Correct. So, AGV are automatically, there is the locations for the auto chargings. And after certain time, when there is no load for that AGV, it goes at certain periods at the charging station. So that simulation is there. Thank you.
Any more questions? May I invite the next presentation from Mahindra Sustain?